You guys look really good, by the way. I feel like a proud mom up here. Good afternoon, classmates, families, friends, and loved ones. It is my pleasure to welcome you to Shorewood's Class of 2022 graduation. For those of you that do not know me, my name is J.C. Gray Hall, the class president. It is my honor to be one of the speakers speaking on behalf of the class today. I have been class president for the class since freshman year. Thank you, class, for believing in my leadership skills for the last 4 years. 4 years, wow. What were you guys thinking? Sometimes, as leaders, we forget our why. As your class president, I was reminded of my why during our time together. I was reminded that words may inspire you, but only actions can create change, a quote by Simon Sinek. I would be lying if I didn't say high school flew by as fast as everyone thought it would. Well, of course, the pandemic, virtual learning, and the rise of TikTok videos has something to do with it. My one and only goal during the pandemic was to become TikTok famous. My heart was set on it. My plan of action was to post a TikTok video daily to all the trending dances, and my goal was to have 50K followers by June. I am sad to say that my highest like count was only like 30, so that quickly became a dream deferred. Some of our fondest moments together during high school were dancing in dance circles at the dances, showing up to basketball and football games just for the upperclassmen to tell us we had to sit in the back. The homecoming week our freshman year, our class showed up and showed out. We rocked out each theme. And if you ask me, I think class of 2019 definitely rigged the votes we should have won. In addition, the moment that stood out to me the most is how we came together as a class in the time of unrest, social and racial justice over the last 4 years. Many of us marched together, became allies, and stood together in solidarity. This made me proud to be a part of this class and community. We are Greyhound strong. Mr. Kinney has always provided a platform for our voices to be heard as youth, and I hope that that is something that will remain a priority here at Shorewood High School. As I mentioned before, words may inspire, but only actions can create change. My call of action to each one of you is to live with no regrets, continue to create memories that will last a lifetime, learn from your mistakes, and remember, opportunities do not happen, you create them. And to remember to stand up for what's right, even if it means standing alone. Class of 2022, as we leave here today, remember we have a legacy as undefeated Powderpuff champions, extraordinary academic and athletic accomplishments, in addition to our ability to stand out musically, theatrically, and in so many artistic ways. As I end my speech, I want to say no matter what we do or where we go, there will be many challenges ahead of us. The action I am calling on each one of you is to meet those challenges straight on with your head held high, and your heart open wide. The future is in your hands. Let's make the most of it. Thank you.
Across an empty land, I knew the pathway like the back of my hand. I felt the earth beneath my feet, sat by the river, and it made me complete. Oh, simple thing, where have you gone? I'm getting old and I need someone. The branches of it looking at me. Is this the place?
Hello, class of 2022. Our high school years have not been defined by ease. Many challenges have attempted to slow our progress. Namely, the COVID-19 pandemic has been a challenge, but we are getting through it. Shorewood High School has provided us with a plethora of opportunities to excel. From extracurricular clubs to advanced placement classes, we have shown that we are capable of much more. We went from ambitious freshmen, unaware of what the next 4 years would bring, perhaps accepting what would transpire as we sailed through high school. We were then, and still are, a class of multicultural students with a comprehensive tapestry of interests, skills, and talents, motivated to leave our mark on society. During sophomore and junior years, we were prematurely exposed to that external world when the COVID-19 pandemic affected our school. We became accustomed to learning from home, seeing our teachers and friends only through our computer screens. But despite these barriers, we have yet again emerged as victors. Our odyssey, though, is not over, as we have much ocean to cross. Our lives are just at the beginning, and we look forward to becoming future artists, performers, teachers, lawyers, scientists, and doctors. Our interests led us to form a broad range of clubs and to mingle into the many other sports and groups present then. Furthermore, the unique combination of devoted teachers, kind volunteers, coaches, and generous contributors continued to enhance our educational experience and developed our skills essential to survive in the outside world. Our principal, counselors, and teachers have left no stone unturned and led Shorewood High School into becoming a greenhouse for growing, fostering great values, increasing our desire to continue pushing forward despite the hurdles we faced. Last but not least, our parents, who supported us all the way. We salute you today. Thank you for investing in us. We will make you proud and use the toolkit you have entrusted to us. From diverse backgrounds we arise and into a cornucopia of institutions around the world we enter in order to continue our education, serve our country, and work and contribute to our community. Our achievements are numerous and our memories infinite. We have grown from ambitious freshmen into powerful, all-knowing seniors. Yet, we are still standing on the shoulders of giants. We went beyond our boundaries to mark ourselves as the next great generation. Don't forget, class of 2022, once a Greyhound, always a Greyhound. Thank you so much, and good luck on your next endeavor.
Good afternoon, Shorewood High School. What an honor it is to have this day, especially after the last couple of years. If you don't know my name is Brian Terry Jr., the voice you hear on the announcements every Tuesday and Thursday morning, giving you the 411 and the 414. And I'm here to tell you that we did it. We put in the hours, we never stopped trying to do our best, and now here we are, closing this chapter of our lives together. We did it. And I'm here to, and Shorewood taught me a few things that I'd like to share with you all today that I think will help us after we conclude graduation. One of them is to really be the change you want to see in the world. If there's a problem you feel passionate about or an achievement you wish to obtain, big or small, it is up to you to push yourself enough to get there. It is no one else's responsibility but your own to make your own visions a reality. And that's a mindset you must carry with you in life. Shorewood has given us the resources to be club leaders, protest organizers, regional and state champions, entrepreneurs, performers, and so much more, all because we've learned to be the change. The biggest lesson I've learned, though, is to never stop trusting yourself. We may not always have the support of our friends and teachers anymore, but it is crucial that no matter how hard times may be, that we trust ourselves that we can pull through it someday. The road to graduation has curved and winded in ways that we never could have believed or imagined. But it taught us that even with the weight of the world against our shoulders, as long as we never lose trust in ourselves, there is absolutely nothing that can stand in our way. Shorewood has given us the balance of guidance and freedom to shape us into functioning young adults that will challenge the world around us. Moving forward, we can look back on this campus when we're driving along Capitol or Oakland and feel a sense of accomplishment, a sense of accomplishment that we've made a lasting impression on the future of Shorewood High School, and in return, a sense of accomplishment that Shorewood High School has made a positive impact on the rest of our lives. Thank you, and congratulations to the class of 2022.
All right. Good afternoon, parents, guardians, caregivers, families, friends, and everyone who is watching us live through our YouTube channel. Good afternoon, Shorewood Orchestra students. Thank you so much for being here with us today. You sound fantastic.
Good afternoon, Shorewood High School staff members who are here with us today, both participating in the ceremony and those who are helping us out behind the scenes. As always, your presence is greatly appreciated. And especially, a huge welcome and good afternoon, class of 2022. You look amazing. Every graduation ceremony is special, and I'm honored to be part of this important time in your life. But this year's a little extra special for me, as I not only get to stand up here and speak, but I'm celebrating with everyone in attendance as one of my sons is about to cross the stage and graduate as well. How fortunate am I? Seniors, let me take you back a moment to September 9th. The day we had our senior class meeting right here together in this auditorium, and we're talking about the importance of getting the school year off to a strong start, because as I mentioned, it was going to feel like you're going to blink twice and you're going to be sitting right where you are right now. It's pretty amazing, isn't it? We also spent time talking about how the senior class sets the tone for the entire school. As the lead class, others are watching you. And as I've had time to reflect back on this school year, I wanted to say thank you to all of you. You have been a great class of leaders who set a strong positive tone as we continue to recover from these last couple of strange and difficult years. So, thank you. You have my tremendous gratitude. You know, because your class, honestly, has probably been the most affected of all the classes over these past 4 years. Your sophomore year ended with a COVID thud. Your junior year was largely virtual with minimal extra activities, and your senior year was a series of disruptions from construction to waves of COVID variants. And yet, you have persevered. And I got to go off script here just for a moment, because as I've been practicing my speech over and over again, the next line, it says, you brought home 2 state championships and a close runner-up, and that was before 5:30 last night. What's up, boys and girls, track and field? So let me amend my speech and go back on script. You brought home 4 state championships and a close runner-up finish, going deep into state-level competition in other sports, both as individuals and as teams. You've brought joy to audiences through our outstanding performing and visual arts. You have positively affected our community through courses such as social justice through image and word, environmental literature, and visual journalism. New Horizons Charter School's steadfast commitment to participation in community partnerships that make other people's lives better through sharing education, sharing experiences, and improving the environment. And all this, and you led Shorewood High School to a state report card score of significantly exceeds expectations, the highest one we've ever had. So I'm thinking to myself as I drafted this speech, how do you share all of this with others that you will meet as you venture outside of the school community? How do you share your resilience and help others to keep a positive outlook on the future ahead? Because these will likely not be the last of difficult times in your lives. And that's when I came back to kindness and gratitude. It's time to change the narrative on the almost daily examples of negativity that we see in the larger world around us. Let's make the focus about all that you have, what you have gained, not what was lost. All these accomplishments that I just listed, be grateful to yourselves for sharing your gifts and talents with each other to achieve these things. Be thankful to those around you who have supported you, and let them know about it. Having gratitude and expressing it is an act of kindness towards others, who in turn will be more inclined to pay it forward. So speaking of kindness and gratitude, though, I want to share a story with you about a remarkable person named Rose Smith. Rose has been a Shorewood resident since 1966. She and her husband Wayne moved here. Her children attended St. Robert's School, but then ultimately Shorewood High School. Rose did a tremendous amount of volunteering within school, supporting school nurses, coordinating field trips, reading to elementary age children, helping out in the main office or anywhere else that was needed. When she wasn't helping out in the schools, she was using her artistic talents to make bridesmaid dresses for others, make floral arrangements for others. She worked in the Shorewood Senior Resource Center, supporting programs, volunteering as a writer for the newsletter, helping others write, and helping organize trip opportunities. Everything that she was doing had a ring of service to others. And while this volunteering and service to others is absolutely a wonderful thing, thinking about the countless lives that were touched by Rose and the lives that were made better because of her kindness, the remarkable part is what life was like before 1966 when Rose was growing up. You see, as a child, Rose's family was quite poor. Making ends meet on a daily basis was a challenge. Rose felt that she needed to do her part to help out her family. And she worked several jobs, all of which paid low wages and were often subjected to people who were demeaning her at those jobs. Despite that, she stuck with it and gave her mother the income that she received from the jobs to help her family. And she was able to do all this work because at 17 years old, Rose had made the difficult decision to drop out of high school to help her parents and siblings. And she never went back, but rather moved forward with the life that I described to you, taking care of others, putting others first. It's been a joyful life, but there's always been a little bit of regret that she never finished high school. As I said before, we see so many counterexamples all around us, and Rose Smith spent a lifetime challenging that narrative. And you know what, class of 2022? Together, we're going to pay that forward. Because despite the fact that Rose Smith never finished high school, she has certainly lived life summa cum laude. And at this time, I would like you to join me, class of 2022, in celebrating Rose Miranda Smith with this honorary Shorewood High School diploma, as I invite her to join me on stage at this time. So this is my challenge that I present to you, class of 2022. Change the narrative. As you take all your skills, knowledge, talents, and experiences forward in life, don't forget that even in what appears to be dark and difficult times, you could always make a difference. And the difference lies grounded in gratitude and kindness. Again, I am truly grateful for all of you. You will be greatly missed, and you have our most heartfelt congratulations. And having said that, Dr. Sternke, it is my great honor and my distinct privilege to present to you the Shorewood High School graduating class of 2022.
Talk about tough acts to follow. It is my distinct privilege to extend a warm welcome again to all of you in attendance today. And let me say how wonderful it is to extend this welcome face-to-face in this beautiful space as we return to commencement in the beautiful Shorewood Auditorium. That being said, I also welcome people that are joining us via streaming. We've learned to do that well in the last few years, and nice to open up that as well. Students, class of 2022, we are here today with a return to in-person learning, but also with a pledge that Principal Kenny made and has worked so hard, that it's not just about the learning, but really coming together around those events that make a school year special. And today, we've worked to have many traditions back in place, and after years, I just want to say you deserve today. It's great to be here, and I am simply so proud to be representing you as your interim superintendent and lead in such a fine school district and in a community that reveres education and supports our schools. So on my behalf, as well as on the behalf of the Board of Education, I extend congratulations to our families, caregivers, guardians, and friends in attendance. Thanks for celebrating this milestone today. You know, milestones are important because they're a marker of time. And I've had three children cross the stage and receive a diploma. So to all of those parents, caregivers, and guardians in the room, I want to reassure you that it's okay that you might be thinking today, it seemed like yesterday, fill in the blank, that we dropped you off at Atwater and Lake Bluff, or I saw you kick a soccer ball for the first time, or pick up a violin. It's okay to reminisce a little bit because we share your pride today. We also extend our gratitude to you for forging a partnership with us that helps create the success we see today. And to our SHS administration, Mr. Kenny, Ms. Jamerson, thank you for doing all you did to prepare our students for today. Ms. Jamerson, in the short time we've worked together, oh, thank you. Ms. Jamerson, in the short time we've worked together, I've come to respect your work ethic, your insight, and your passion for helping students be all they can be. Before today's commencement, I was talking with Amanda around students, around you, and she talked with such pride about your successes, naming many, many of you. And Mr. Kenny, you were the first leader I met when I came to Shorewood this year. Your passion for Shorewood High School in this district is a touchstone for me. Thanks for your enthusiastic, student-centered, and thoughtful leadership. I've worked with many educational leaders over my career, and you are among the very best. And to our faculty and staff, those present today, and those who over the years have given students their best but aren't with us today, teachers at the high school or SIS or Atwater and Lake Bluff, thank you. I admire not only how much you care about students, but I admire the agility you too have experienced and demonstrated with such professionalism in the last few years. But what I really marvel at is you amaze me how you inspire our students to find their passions. I often work with teachers who care and staff who care, but I think you help students communicate with clarity and expression, bar none. You help these great students become citizens, able to be themselves, comfortable in their own skin, and able to navigate and be successful in a complex world. Teachers, staff, you have my respect. And saving the best for last, I want to thank our orchestra students and our stagehands for being here today. But most of all, I want to congratulate our class of 2022. We've talked a lot today about your compassion, around your resilience, around your many, many accomplishments. And I just want to say something simple. You are filled with joy in this room because you're surrounded by people who believe in you, people who hold big hopes and dreams for you, your friends, your family, people who are confident in your success, in all you will be, do, and accomplish. And as Mr. Kenny texted me this morning, he said, today is going to be epic because this is an epic class. It's epic. You're going to be epic. So, you know, at these ceremonies, we look back, we look forward, And that's kind of what we do at commencement ceremonies. We talk about things being over, we sing about things being over, and things just beginning. That's the paradox of commencements. It seems a contradiction of sorts. We look back, we look forward. It has one truth, but there's many truths underneath. Commencements are paradoxical because it feels like an end to high school, but also a beginning to a great future. It's also paradoxical that I would bet you are feeling many, many different things. Relief, excitement, happiness, sadness. It's paradoxical that you feel a lot of conflicted emotions on a day like today. You like wearing a mortarboard, but you wonder how it all works. That's a paradox, too. I think paradoxes are what gives richness to life. They're unexpected, they add depth. They allow you to feel multiple emotions at the same time. And I really just want to encourage you to celebrate paradoxes. I'm experiencing a paradox right now on this stage. I'm here living a dream. I'm living the dream that you can't come home again, but you can. I've returned to, as interim superintendent, to a place that I called home as a teacher for 10 years. And this auditorium holds amazing memories for me. When I was a Shorewood High School teacher, I ran graduation, and I lined people up just like Ms. Schwinn did. And I remember our new principal at that time, Jack Linehan, who went on to become superintendent. He fainted at his first graduation, and I'm not joking, his size 13 feet were right there for everyone to see as he fainted. I have to say that he was fine afterwards, but I also want to tell Mr. Kenny, no stress, just relax. But when I say I began my career here, I say it because this building shaped me as a person. I came here to student teach drama and English, and I stayed for 10 years. I directed no less than 20 shows in this auditorium, and I worked on many, many more with my mentor, Barbara Gensler, who taught me the importance of hard work, creative insight, and how to put passion in action. Those were all things I want for you students. When I saw Fiddler this year, our first show, or Cinderella, it brought me home about why I love drama so much. And when I've attended the many band and choir and orchestra concerts this year, I really realized this is a great place to come home to. We celebrate the arts. And when I watched the reclamation, I realized how special it is to be in a school that celebrates student voice. When I went to see cross country or mountain biking or soccer or many other sports, I thought about how great it is to have a well-rounded experience. And I want to tell you, sometimes your memories about home aren't that great, but for me, it's even better the second time around. Paradoxically, my most important leadership lessons were learned here from Mr. Linehan when he wasn't fainting, or Barbara Gensler, or from the many colleagues who I admired so much as teachers. I ask you students to think about who are those people here who've shaped your life? And after you think about paradoxes, here's another one. As much as I would love to give you tons of advice, I know that this day isn't about me, it's about you. And the longer I talk, the longer it will take for you to receive your diploma and move that tassel to the other side. So I want to close without a paradox, but just one piece of advice. As much as this day is about you, and it is, there is a paradox. It's also about many others. And here's what I challenge you, class of 2022. Find a couple people in this room or not in this room. Write them a note, send them an email, a text, or use your voice and let them know how they helped you get to this point and how they're shaping your future. Those small things, just like we saw happen across stage, mean the world to people. Celebrate and lean into paradoxes. They add richness to life. And now, Mr. Kenny, I ask you, will the class of 2022 please step forward?
And now the moment we've all been waiting for. I'm Associate Principal Jamerson, and I just want to remind everyone, as I read the names, we want you to cheer, we want you to be excited, but we do ask that you cheer for every student as they walk across the stage. Okay. Donna Ali Alanjami. Melina Zoe Angelis. Elise Arndt. Lily Bernadette Aubin. Giuseppe Balestrieri. Amanita Nia Maria Barrel. Anna Gudelari. Theo Burgess. Ruben Wolf Berkowitz. Stanley Lucas Berry. Shai Beener. Oscar Joseph Bockhorst. Miles Bowen. Zoe Brim Harris. Ashe Ali Bryant. Nicholas Bucciarelli. Simon Wilk Burnham. Harmony Burton. Sage Boozer. Melissa Chug. Salamuet Eden Caldart. Amelia Grace Calderon Hennis. Rebecca Judith Cheever. Henry McKnight Clausen. Yeah. Anaya Satraho Elaine Klaus. Kendall June Cole. Isabel Riley Colvin. Quinn Patrick Corcoran. Juliet Elizabeth Corey. Maxwell James Sharp Curro. Ava Charlize Danzer. Amarion Davis. Madison Mary Davis. Gideon Kai Deek. Luke Jason Dess. Riju Day. Margaret Grace Dickman. Sophia Rose DeLiberti. Jacob Donahue. Aaliyah Duckworth. Megan Elizabeth Dolmes. Leo William Forbeck Dunsarin. Liam Harrison Eichhoff. Rana Eitel. Anika Lauren Elliott. Olivia Ryan Nicole Evans. Alexander Fitch. Elaine Anna Frazier. Ada Ganther. Kenya Serena Gaston. Sarus James Gujala. Isabella Glenn. Noe Laura Goldhaber. Nathan Robert Gossi. Chasey Gray Hall. Kyle John Griswold. Peter Martin Gugulari. Alexander James Hasse. Ren Celine Haid. Lane Julia Meyer Hammond. Nicholas Arthur Hansman. Sajan Xander Hadrath. Charles David Hellman. Julian Herzing Burkhard. Henry Stephen Hayden. Sarah Hopper. Lillian Hudson. Brianna Nicole Jackson. Isabella Claire Jackson. Noel Johnson. Savannah Johnson. Amari Leandre Jolly. Logan Kadrovec. Mira Cajate de Souza. Samuel Brian Casper, sorry. Gavin Richard Kinney. Zoe Min Fulu Kern. in loving memory, Jackson Martin Knorschild. Lisa Coralove. Dennis Kurchenkov. Amelia Teresa Kinnan. Michaela Lawrence. Tyler Michael Van Lee. Eli Levitis Gorin. Pornapa Lazamchala Beauty. Isabella Rose Lozier. Paisley Lynn Dreswicki Lucier. Jack Makowski. Charles Henry Marble. Mark Marty. Jalen Martinez Ortiz. Clara Ann McElfrish. Ethan McCullough McCaig. Megan Claire McLeod. Auden Joseph Medley. Quentin Lacroix Medley. Mary Catherine Meir. Sunita Menon. Abby Grace Milnicki. Kaylon May Megan. Luke Miller. Virginia Rose Mitchell. Zachary David Muchala. Armani Monique Nash. Reese William Bardeen Nelson. Leo Elliott Levine Newman. Madeline Grace Ann O'Connell. Adam Grant O'Connor. Will James O'Connor. Ketawan Yael Ocasio-Vasquez. Grace Optikar. Michaela Alexis Pappas. Tay San Park. Benjamin Patton Pett. Emily Grace Patzer. Mitchell D. Paulwolf. Bella Ann Peasley. Juliet Addison Pertarka. Madeline Danes Placon. George James Meisner Pritchard. Aiden Christopher Pritchett. Leo Felix Evo Prozen Aldani. Jamie Marie Puppy. Jamil Rashada. Jack William Reinhofer. Benjamin Rickheimer. Gabriele Rizzo. Luca Ryan Rongstad. Jeremiah Lee Rosenblatt. Peyton Hamilton Roth. William Rowden. Miyako Mae Sakai. Pramana Salden. John Santino Sanfilippo. Juan Marcos Santana Burnett. Jaden Christine Schultz. Nolan Patrick Shawblack. Mariana Juliet Schaefer. Chie Shay Shadu. Georgia Lynn Siegel. Jacob Maxwell Silverberg. Fiona Ann Skorowski. Graham Russell Stearns. Ellie Dea Sweet. Brian Scott Terry. Rose Guess Tisso. Ksenia Tico. Jack Hansen Trost. Ava Luna Vogel Del Valle. Leif A. Walterman. Isaac Jacob Wong. Owen Weiss. Yeah, Owen. Carmen Elise Wilder. Calvin Wesley Willie. Avery Marcourt Walanowski. Catherine Emily Young. Sloan Storms Zahner. Henry Alexander Zhang. Dario Zuccarello. Congratulations, class of 2022. Immediately following the recessional class of 2022, we want you to meet on the front lawn. We have a drone, and we want to get a photo of all of you together. So at the end, we'll do that. And then we also have light refreshments in the admin building on the first and second floor.